Hey, what is up, guys? After today's video, I did like a live stream and I pushed live on stream back to the spot on top of the world, number one global. And we faced some really, really difficult matchups and we faced some snipes. We got sniped here from this guy, Andres the Boss. You can't tell me you're running Zap and Snowball. He played the game before the Fireball Zap version, the normal Lava Loom version, but he played Snowball and Zap. So this is a really, really tough matchup because he knew and we were like searching for opponent. And in this video, I'm gonna show you how you beat the toughest, most difficult matchups with this minor Wallbreaker deck. If you guys want to see more videos like that, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Don't forget to use creator code Morten in the shop. And I'm gonna see you in the first game. Let's go. By the way, thanks for all the feedback on my last video. Let's go. So guys, you're in the first game and we start off the video with a game against one of the best players in the world, against a CRL player, number one finisher on ladder, Lucas X Gamer. You guys know him, he is a really, really good player. At this point, he was top 5 in the world with this World Giant deck. This is not an easy matchup. The reason is why he has the Fisherman against our Miner, he was Hunter, bats really, really cheap cycles. So overall, I would say this isn't an easy matchup. This is like really, really tough to play. I think I lost earlier against Lucas as well, like one day ago. So this shows like this matchup isn't easy if your opponent plays perfect. And Lucas is a really, really good RG player as well. I think he finished really high last season with it, or at least he used it and was like high like most of the season. So yeah, I think I went like left side. The reason is, you guys will see I'm gonna play like really, really weird way for most of you guys, because he can, this is like the thing, he can always slow wall with the World Giant in the back, and for me, I would say it's harder to win than for him, because he can always play the World Giant in the back, he can log skellies, the wall break, he can Fisherman the Miner, so for him it's kind of easy to do that. So I really need to be careful with applying pressure. Don't apply too much pressure, that I'm like in a big elixir disadvantage. And I always like to go in like opposite lane here, kind of play the mine like that, because if your opponent is going for Hunter, that's fine. And I always try to defend one Royal Giant if he plays the Royal Giant in the back without a Bomb Tower. The reason is why, if I go for Bomb Tower on the Royal Giant, he can just first, Bomb Tower is not enough for Royal Giant, so I need to go in with Royal Giant plus bats. This is like an even elixir trade for sure, but then he has another Royal Giant.
Nani?
I don't have bats, I don't have Voyager, I don't have Bomb Tower, and then it's gonna be tough because it's so many hits that I can't really punish him for that. So, as you guys saw, I went with bats, Knight on his first Royal Giant. Now I'm just gonna go for Knight, Bomb Tower, cleaning everything up, great splash value here, and this is just an easy defense. Let's go! So, going with bats here behind the boy, going with Maya on the opposite side, kind of pressing. He got a lock and then knew he still has to use the lock because of my lock, the Warbeck would have connected and splashed the Ewis as well. So he's not happy about that. We are going in with the Spirits at the bridge just to chip a bit. He's gonna do that. And I'm just kind of trying to keep up the pressure here. He's gonna use that. This is kind of fine for us. I think I'm just gonna lock here. Yeah, with a good lock timing, the Ewis just gets one hit. If you kind of miss the lock timing, it's getting two hits. And yeah, going in again here because I know he doesn't have bats and cycles, so we're going for Miner here in the back, going for Wallbreaker as well. Kind of unfortunate Wallbreaker timing, so he's still using his skeletons in the full Miner's connecting. So, small mistake by us, we could have waited a bit more. Going with Knight now to the right side, kind of chill a bit, and let's see how is he gonna respond to it. We go with high bats because I know he doesn't have Electrospirit in his deck. Against Electrospirit, it's even more tough, so I would say like if he has Electrospirit instead of bats or something, it's really, really tough. So I go for defensive Miner and that. Because I don't really want to take like two giant hits. I know it's a kind of overcommitment, but it's fine. Going with Betsy, going for Warbeck to the right. Just going to lock here in case he goes to skeletons, but he already used them in the middle. So I'm kind of spitting up my damage, which is like honestly great in this matchup. You want to have that to happen because you don't really want to push the same lane as the Royal Giant player. So he's switching up lanes, but we're able to switching up lanes as well, because the Royal Giant player wants to always go the same lane as you're pushing, because then he can create a counter push. But because we switch up the pressure, is completely fine. Going with a lock prediction here, and because of the lock prediction here, he still has to commit Ewis, and you guys see he's gonna get two Royal Giants on this side, but now we can just easily defend this. We're gonna let it go because I know it's just to use a lock, and we're completely fine here. Knight is still there. We're going with bats here just to get some chippy. Going for lock first. Great log, by the way. We're hitting the E-Wiz as well. Going for mine in the back, going with Spearcops now at the bridge. He still has to use the log, and even with the log, still the bat is connecting, chipping away. He has to use late bats, and the bat was already at his tower, and we're getting great amount of chipping. Going with bat just to distract here, playing it as high as possible, because then the hunter is not getting too much splash, still one splash hit. We're going with Spearcops 2. Spearcops still would have gotten hit, but he's gonna use the E-Wiz. We're going for mine and back. We're gonna use the log on the right side. It's kinda hard to commentate in triple legs at times. So much going on. Bats to the left. Spearcops now. Miner. Log. Bats high. And now I think I'm just gonna drop a miner. Gonna go for Warbag. Really aggressive. I know he can use a fireball, but if he's using a fireball, it's not gonna be enough. We go for log on the left side just to make sure the hunter's not chipping away too much. Going for fireball over here. Going with another mine in the back. And this looks really, really clean. Crispy clean. Going in with a Spearcops. Going for log. And this is it. Really, really nice game against Lucas X Gamer, one of the best players in the world. I'm gonna see you in the next one. Let's go. So, guys, here in the next game, I'm gonna show you the game against Kamikaze. Much respect to him. He is the best giant player in the world. I mean, really, like, I don't really know how, but he's so high with giant. He's the only giant player in the top 50 global. And I'm gonna show you guys how to beat this deck and how to beat him in general. So he's kind of messing up his E-Wiz. You can play the E-Wiz in a better spot than the, how's it called, the Warbag is not connecting, but we failed the bats, the Spearcops also. I'm like, okay bro, you messed up your E-Wiz, I'm messing up my Spearcops, so to have like a fair game, you know. I'm a nice guy. He's gonna drop his giant in the back now, and it's not an easy matchup. It's kind of annoying for me. I can't really overcommit. I always say it like in kind of every matchup, you can't overcommit. I think it's like honest, an honest point, but you really need to be careful with when you play a wall breaker, how you play a wall breaker, and in which situation you go in with minor bats and minor Spearcops. So going for bomb tower, going with that. I know he doesn't have bats, zap and psychic, so he goes bats as well. And yeah, kind of not a really good defense, because as you guys see, for sure, the knight is really, really good and one of the best cards in the game right now, but still, knight isn't doing well against prince, especially if the prince is charging, so we might get in trouble later on in the game, or we will get in trouble in some situations, but kind of chill, calm down, and yeah, so I think this situation I love to do in this matchup, Warbreaker split is honestly a really good move, because if he doesn't have E-Wiz, it's really hard for him to do, because he can't play like Megami and Dark Prince, but that's like a huge negative elixir trade. So I know his step is out of cycle, so I'm just gonna do that. And in this spot, I'm just going Warbreaker opposite, because he can use his Prince, yes, but if he's gonna use his Prince, this is not optimal for him. So he's just gonna let it connect. He kinda is baiting out, he's gonna play not anything on the bats because he didn't have anything, but he's playing his prince in the back, so in case I'm gonna go for minor, I can't redo it. I'm gonna go for minor to the right because I know if he doesn't have his prince in cycle, his only chance to go for E-Wiz, and he doesn't really want to do that. So, one Warbreaker is not connected. Really, really great Mega Minion placement, honestly. So he's gonna zap this, and we're dropping Spear Gums over here. This is kind of unfortunate. Now I need to go for Warbreak on the right side, and now I still need to lock. It's kind of unfortunate, kind of a bit unlucky that he will survive, but it's still fine. We're kind of down from damage because we kind of need the knight for his prince, princess, and then he can just get like minor chip, and this is like really, really not really, really nice, and we need to really be careful about that. So we go for minor back. This Warbreakers were really, really bad. I don't really know. I think this giant was a small mistake by him. But you guys see the miners chipping away, and we're kind of ahead of damage from damage now. So we're going for fire. No, we're not even gonna drop a fire, but we're just gonna go play high bats. High bats are perfect. He's gonna zap that. But look at the log. Defensive miner going for log. Perfect defense once again. Or like not once again, but a really good defense this time. We're going for wall breaker defensive. Kinda kite the Dark Prince over. Make sure the Dark Prince is not gonna charge to our tower.
I don't know what this is, but it's kind of hot.
So guys, we are back. Sorry guys, my memory was like full for my PC because I had so much stuff on that. So my recording was like, my PC, my OBS said, yeah, you don't have memories anymore on your PC, so I need to delete something. But we are back here. And yeah, this is the situation we were talking about. It's like still a great position to be in, honestly, because we can pressure him now and we win the game. This is like with 90% of the matchups. If the tower, this is like a 500 HP to 500 HP game, you most of the time win because you have a faster cycle and you have the miner. For sure it's the miner too, but our cycle is so much faster and we can defend his miner with a knight. So going in for bomb tower just to make sure. I think I'm gonna drop high bats. This is what I would do, at least go with minor bets. Here, he's gonna use that. I don't really think he's gonna defend it, he doesn't really care about that. And I think he is gonna drop an Evis like that. And I think with the Evis, he has to fireball that, but still he has a great push on that. I think he's not gonna overcommit for minor. Unfortunately, Prince would have charged, but great lock here. Going with high bets, going now with Warbreaker, minor on the right side. Yes, we also know he's low on Elixir. Great Spear Ghost placement, by the way. Spinning it off, going with the log, Miner is connecting, Fireball on the tower, taking it up against Kamikaze, one of the best players in the world, the best giant player in my opinion right now. And I would say we're gonna jump into the last game for this episode against Lavahorn, the toughest matchup for this deck. So guys, now we're in a game against Andres the Boss, and he plays Lavahorn. Lavahorn isn't easy, with Skeleton Ranks as well, but he's like, oh, Morten, come on man, Lavahorn with Skeleton Ranks with Fireball Zap isn't enough. I don't really, man, I know I play against Mod. I don't need a fireball. Let's put a snowball in. So, Lavahorn fireball, Lavahorn snowball zap. This is not an easy task to do, right? We're going for a big opposite. I'm like, okay, he has to use barbs. And I'm like, okay, now we will get great bats for you. And he's just going to go on with Skelnix Bridge. I'm like, okay, we are just going to fireball it. And in this scenario, I knew I was like up 10,000 elixir. So I go off a knight at the bridge, be going in with the spirits. I'm like, okay, this is great. And he's like, hello, bro, you just used the zap, why do you have snowballs run? Like, oh, okay, we got sniped. So I was not angry, but I was like, man, you can't do it against me. I will try my best to beat you. So the situation wasn't good. I think the push was really, really great in case he didn't have snowball. And who can think like that he has snowball and zap? So we go for minor, go with bats too. We go for knight opposite. Why we go for knight opposite? Because he still has to defend, or like, he, I don't really like to go with minor warp against situation because it's just gonna ignore it. It's like how lava players are playing and they have to play. So going for knight in the bridge because knight he always has to defend, otherwise it's like really, really cheap your tower. We're getting a lot of chip damage, but right now I'm like, okay bro, we will lose our tower anyway. He has snowball and cycle, so how am I supposed to defend this? So he's keeping a snowball ready and he's just gonna snowball the bats. No, and this is it. This is it, tower down. I can't defend this. I could fireball it, but then he's just gonna immediately go in with Skull Knights and the bridge, and this is not good. And I'm like getting free drawn. So, yeah, not the best position, honestly. Single Elixir time is really important against Lavahorn. Honestly, it's like really important. The first Lavahorn is really important for you. If you get a lot of damage with the first Lavahorn, it's fine. It's a good situation. If you don't get a lot of damage with the first Lavahorn, it's not optimal. So, I really placed the first Lavahorn. So he's going with Spear Gobs and going for minor wall breaker to the opposite side because I really want to get chip damage. And that was a bit unfortunate, honestly. I don't really want to push the same lane. I know I'm still getting his right tower because of minor chip. But you guys will see. I thought I lost. So he goes with Spear Gobs over here. He's just going to use a snowball like that. So I think I'm using my Bomb Tower like that, kind of get death damage to go for minor here. He's not predicting a minor, so this is great. Fortunate for us, the balloon's not gonna get any hits. And yeah, I had to fireball this, like there was no choice. Go with Warbreaker to the left because then I'm forcing out his Tombstorm, and he's just gonna drop a Mega Mini. But I know right now he didn't have anything in cycle, but right, this is gonna be really, really close. Go with bats, go for minor on Star because I know he can't really do anything against that. And you guys will see how close it's gonna be. He could have snowballed, honestly, my tower. But, whoa, but he didn't. So we go for Wallbreaker, going for log 2, and I think, is it a, yeah, that's the Wallbreaker hit. I bought it, and he knows it too. So he's now going in with a Wallbreaker, with that at the bridge, and I saw no zap, no snowball, no barbarian cycle. So how are you gonna use this, like, how you defend minor bats with knight in the pocket? Going for mine on the safe spot, going for knight bats in the pocket. Warbreaker the bridge, gonna lock predictive here is Tombstone to kill the skeletons, and the miner chipping away. Not enough yet, but for me it was really important now going in with the miner as soon as possible. Because if I go in with the miner, he can't really go all in. And I know if he's gonna go in, it's really tough for me to defend. So I go for miner here, he doesn't have enough links for barbarians, going with that in the pocket. And this is gonna be it. GG's, well played. If you guys don't wanna miss any videos in the future, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Don't forget to use the code MORTON in the shop. And I'm gonna see you in one of my next videos. Peace out, thanks for watching, and goodbye.